Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine. I have a 7-card spread here for you. Y'all, this is going to be quick because, as you know, or for those of you that don't know, I'm homesick. I have pneumonia in my left lung, and I tested positive for the virus, okay? As you know, I'm a frontline worker, and I'm around these sick people every day. There's no guarantee that I picked it up at work, because at work I'm fully protected. So I'm thinking more I might have picked up the virus on the outside, you know, maybe when I run to the store or whatever, because I'm not fully protected then. So I can't really tell you when or where I might have picked it up. On Thursday, I was extremely sick. When I went to work on Friday, I became ill. So I had to go down to the emergency room because I had a sore throat and earache and I was nauseated. Well, they did x-rays and said that I had pneumonia in the left lung. And when they did the virus test, I can't use the C word, y'all. Y'all know that. Well, they came back positive. So now I'm on quarantined. I have been to the ER twice. They did a IV infusion where they gave me antibodies, plasma from another person to help me build my antibodies up to help fight the virus off. I'm short of breath. It's been hard for me to even do a video. This will be the first one that I'm going to do since I've been sick. So please forgive me if I get short of breath and have to stop, okay? I'm going to try to get through this as quick as I can. I did a prayer circle today at 7 o'clock. I hope most of you joined me. I'm trying to send vibes to the universe for healing. I've called upon my spirit guides, have candles lit, and I'm doing everything the doctors have asked me to do. So it's kind of difficult to talk because I keep running out of breath. This video is going to be about Jacqueline West and Orrin and Olson. It's a part two. This was requested by somebody, and I'm doing videos because I can't let my page go down. I'm trying to keep it up, okay? It's been a few days since I've done one, so I gotta get going on this. So try to bear with me, okay? Because I'm running out of breath. All right, so we all know this video is not made for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now. Also, for a personal reading, you can contact me with the information down below. That's about all I can say. Everything else is in the disclaimer box. Okay, so I asked the cards what are Jacqueline Smith's thoughts about what happened, because I don't feel like this was more her idea than it was her husband's. I feel like she was kind of talked into this. So, you know, if you haven't watched my first video, go watch it first, and then you can understand what this one's about. Okay, and then I asked about the final outcome for those two missing children. And what would it be? I did ask if the children already had expired, and I'll tell you what I got on that. So, sorry, y'all, I'm having trouble breathing. I'm telling you, this virus is no joke, man. It does attack your lungs, and at the end, I'll talk about all my symptoms that I've had. Okay, so for the first one, we have the 7 of Wands in the upright. So I feel like this is her current mental state right now, or her current state. Fighting everyone, fighting back. She's fighting because, you know, they're getting a lot of flack from their relatives and people around them, you know, everything on the internet. And I feel like she's just defending herself. This is about defending yourself. She's in her mind about it. See the blue in the background? This represents her defending in deep thought, and she's defending herself. So I feel like she's in that current mode right now. She's having to fight back, defend. I asked about, you know, was this her idea or not? I feel like this was something she just went along with. In my first video, I did say that the children were sold. And I feel like when her husband came to her with this idea, she just pretty much went along with it. Because I feel like he controls her. I don't feel like she thinks for herself. I feel like whatever it is that he says, she just goes along with it. Okay, so she's kind of like one of those women that don't really think for themselves. She just goes along with whatever her man tells her to do. But now with what's happened, I feel like she's constantly in her mind about defending herself, defending her husband, and things like that. God, I'm so short of breath, y'all. Okay, so for the next one we have is the Hierophant. This is the Lure of Conformity. So again, this is confirming that everything I have said is true, has come true, or is coming to pass. This is the judge, you know, with his hands up in the air, confirming, you know, the truth. So with this card, truths do come out. Okay, so I do feel like the truth is coming about the children, and it's going to confirm the truth of what really happened to them. We're going to find out what happened to them. And this card is just here to remind you that the truth is coming. That's why it's called the lure of conformity. So, oh my God, I'm getting a wave of nausea. Okay, hold on. Whew, Jesus. Okay, let me get through this quick, y'all, because I'm still very ill. Okay, so for the next one, we have the Ten of Swords. So with this card, this is the end of a karmic cycle. So I feel like this is what's coming for her, and this is what's coming for them because of what they did. And then the truth, see, is right next to the truth. It's right next to conformity. So when this truth comes out, they're going to have an end of a karmic cycle. So their way of life is going to be is coming to an end. The way they've been living, everything they've known, the way they live, you know, meaning their lifestyle, all that is coming to an end when the truth comes out, because they're going to end up in jail. And these are jail bars here. These represent jail bars. According to what question is asked and what position it falls on, this is them in jail. Okay, so I do feel like they will go to jail when the truth comes out here. I feel like their time is almost up. I'm seeing the number 10, maybe anywhere from 10 weeks to 10 months. Okay, bear with me, y'all. I keep losing my breath. Okay, so now this is the Seven of Swords. See, this is a very sneaky person. So I feel like this was her husband being very sneaky when he stole the children. See how this man is looking behind him? He's stealing the swords, tiptoeing, making sure that nobody is watching him. These card chants back here represent all kinds of stuff like sexual activity, child pornography, you know, things like that. And this came out in the first reading that I had about them. This represented him in the first reading. So it did come out. But it's in the reverse. So that represents truths, more truths coming out. See, here are the two swords left behind, which is evidence. Okay, so when it's in the reverse, that means that the evidence is going to be found and the truth is coming out. So again, this goes hand in hand with these three cards here. The lure of conformity, truth coming out. End of a karmic cycle, truth coming out. So there's a lot of truths here coming out that's going to, you know, bring their end of their karmic cycle. Them living together, going, you know, in the way of life that they're living, that's all coming to an end because the truth will come out. So now we have the Two of Swords. This was her, I feel like, during that time when they were trying to make a decision, they were at a crossroads, deep in their mind about the situation, what should they do. In my first video, I said that they were approached by someone with a proposition for selling the children, and I feel like they were at a crossroads about it. I feel like they thought about it for a while because they're in deep thought here, didn't know which way to go. Their finances were in terrible, terrible state. So I feel like when they were approached with this proposition, they made that decision and crossed that crossroad. And yeah, the decision was made. That's what that represents right there. With this card, the Two of Swords in the reverse, it represents things moving, occurring quickly. So I do see when these three cards, when the truth comes out here, things are gonna occur quickly. And one of them is gonna trip up, okay? One of them is gonna say something to somebody that's gonna get them caught, because this is a card reminds you not to share any confidences. So one of them is going to trip up and they're going to tell somebody something that's going to get them caught. And that's where it falls right under the lure of conformity. See, so this is what I'm saying right now. Listen to what I'm saying, okay? Because one of them, whether it be her or him, and I think it's more her, she's going to say something to somebody which is going to trip her up. And that whoever she says it to, they're going to tell the authorities. And then, see, right underneath it falls a justice card. Okay, so it's going to trip them up, and then the truth is going to spill. All right, so here I see the Five of Wands, this is a lot of scattered weird energy for them. There's a lot of arguments for them, fighting. They're even fighting each other, although we don't see that because we don't know what goes on in their private lives. I do see them fighting each other, arguing, because they're feeling a lot of intense emotions over this. You know, he fights with her, she fights back, then, you know, just back and forth, back and forth. I see it. And then other people fight with them, like the baby's relatives. And, you know, stuff like that. So I do see a lot of argument, a lot of scattered energy. This is people fighting all over the place. They're in their mind about this a lot because they can't get out of their mind about it now because they know they're in trouble. Okay. But the main thing, y'all, the main thing is when this confidence is shared, she, I believe it's going to be her, is going to tell somebody something, one little small detail. She's going to slip up, and that person's going to run to the authorities and tell. Okay. So I asked, will these two children be found? Are they dead or alive? It didn't give me a answer of dead or alive, but it did give me that there will be justice for these children. See, here comes the justice card. The scales are balanced. Okay. So when the scales are balanced here, that means there will be justice for these children. And then we will know the truth. And it falls again. I mean, these cards, it's just cut and dry. You couldn't tell. You couldn't get any better reading than this. It's just cut and dry here. The lure of conformity, them going to jail, the end of their lifestyle, the truth coming out here where they were stolen, the truth. There's evidence here behind. What's the evidence, okay? When she tells somebody something, they run and tell the police. I mean, it's all here. Cut and dry. And I can't wait for that day. I can't wait for that day to come. When they find out the truth about these children, there will be y'all a part three to this because I gotta go. Y'all, I'm very, very ill. Now, let me tell you about my symptoms. I was sick on Thursday with nausea. I had a little bit of diarrhea, and then the next day when I had to go to work on Friday, I woke up with fever. I had a sore throat and an earache, so I went down to the emergency room. Okay, they took x-rays of my chest and they told me I had pneumonia in the left lung. Okay, so they did a strep test for my throat. They did a flu swab and the virus swab. I'm going to call it the virus because I can't use the C word. They did that swab. Okay, the strep came back negative, the flu came back negative, but the virus one came back positive. So yes, I have it. I'm positive. Okay, so they put me on quarantine. They gave me a bunch of meds to take. Yesterday, I had to go back to the hospital. They did an IV infusion, meaning they gave me somebody else's antibodies through their plasma to help me fight off the virus because I'm not fighting it off too well. My body's only because I have pre-existing conditions. Y'all know I have diabetes and other problems, so my body's having a hard time fighting it off. So they give me other people's antibodies that are healthy to help me fight it off. That took about 6 hours. I was sitting there in a chair with the IV in my arm for about 6 hours. Okay. My fever's gone up and down, but for 5 days straight, I've had 100 temperature, which has made me nauseous. I'm so nauseous. I've lost my taste. I get tremendous headaches. My balance is off. I'm very short of breath. They gave me an inhaler, you know, and cough medicine. I haven't had that much cough, though. And then the antibiotics I'm taking. But I'm doing everything I can, y'all, to fight this off. Please, y'all, keep wearing your mask. Wash your hands. I have taken every precaution, and I still got it. So please be careful when you're out there because this is no joke. This is one of the hardest, ugliest viruses that I've ever had. And it's very hard to fight off. And I'm in my 50s. I'm not that young. And I have diabetes. So I have a pre-existing condition that could, you know, really affect me in a bad way. But I'm doing everything I can to fight it off. Today I had the prayer vigil at 7 o'clock. I hope most of you joined me on that. Wherever you were, it doesn't matter if you're in your car, home, or wherever, you can pray. Because the universe can hear you. My mother and some of my ancestors were on the phone. And we all did a prayer circle on the phone. And we lit candles. And I called out to my spirit guides and the universe for healing. And I see a lot of things in the candle. And I know that they heard me. I know my spirit guides are here with me. I asked for them to cleanse my body, take all this away from me so I can be back to my normal self. I'm going to continue trying to make videos and keep my page going. Y'all, thank you so much for supporting me. and I love all of you, and I will hope to see you soon in a live. When I get better, I will do a live and do some more free readings. All right, y'all. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.